गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू केमिस्ट्री वीडियो क्लास। इन दिस क्लास वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट हाइड्रोजन क्लोराइड एंड ऑक्सो एसिड्स ऑफ क्लोरीन। हाइड्रोजन क्लोराइड एंड ऑक्सो एसिड्स ऑफ क्लोरीन, दीज टू टॉपिक्स वी विल डिस्कस इन दिस वीडियो। फर्स्ट हाइड्रोजन क्लोराइड। सो हाउ टू प्रिपेयर हाइड्रोजन क्लोराइड इन लैबोरेटरी मेथड। इन लैबोरेटरी मेथड हाइड्रोजन क्लोराइड प्रिपेयर्ड by heating a mixture of sodium chloride with concentrated H2SO4, sodium chloride with concentrated H2SO4, we will get HCl, NaCl plus H2SO4, we will get NaHSO4 and HCl. Here NaHSO4 is called sodium bisulfate or sodium hydrogen sulfate. This is further react with NaCl, we will get HCl. This is the only preparation method for HCl. Here the HCl gas can be dried by passing over concentrated sulfuric acid. This point is very, very important. So how to dried HCl gas? HCl gas is dried by passing over concentrated sulfuric acid. Next, physical properties of HCl. HCl is a pungent smelling gas. It can be easily liquefied to form a colorless liquid. That means it is easily converted into liquid. So liquid HCl boils at 189 Kelvin and freezes to a colorless solid at 150 Kelvin. So what is the boiling point of liquid HCl? 189 Kelvin. And what is the freezing point of HCl? 150 Kelvin. See here, this is very important point. HCl is highly soluble in water and its aqueous solution is called hydrochloric acid. That is the difference between hydrochloric acid and hydrogen chloride. So what is the difference between hydrochloric acid and hydrogen chloride? Hydrochloric acid is, when hydrogen chloride is soluble in water, we will get hydrochloric acid. Hydrogen chloride is just gas. That is the difference between hydrogen chloride and hydrochloric acid. This is aqueous, this is gas. Next, chemical properties. First one, acidic nature. So HCl is highly soluble in water, as we in physical properties we discussed. Its Ka value is 10^7. Dissociation constant of acid is 10^7. Higher the Ka value, higher is the acidic nature. So that's why HCl is a stronger acid. How can you say HCl is stronger acid? Because its Ka value is 10^7. And moreover, when HCl gas is dissolved in water, it gives hydronium ions. So if any substance liberates hydronium ions in water, it is said to be acidic in nature. Next, another proof is HCl is acidic or not. When HCl react with ammonia, so ammonia is basic in nature. It forms dense white fumes of ammonium chloride. This reaction indicates acidic nature of HCl. Clear? What is the Ka value of HCl? 10^7. What happen when HCl react with ammonia? We will get dense white fumes of solid NH4Cl, that is ammonium chloride. Next, reaction with HNO3. So what is HNO3, students? Nitric acid. See here, one important point you have to remember. I think you know this point in your lower classes also. A mixture of 3 parts of concentrated HCl and 1 part of concentrated HNO3. 3 parts of concentrated HCl and 1 part of concentrated HNO3 is known as aqua regia. So it is used to dissolve noble metals like gold and platinum. So what is the use of aqua regia? So used to dissolve noble metals like gold and platinum. Gold and platinum can dissolve by using aqua regia. Next, so what happen when aqua regia react with gold and platinum? Now we will discuss. See, these two reactions are very very important for objective examination rather than subjective examination. See, when gold react with HNO3 plus HCl mixture, HNO3 plus HCl mixture is called what? Aqua regia. Here, what is the common point in HNO3 and HCl? H plus ion is the common. So that's why I wrote separately H plus ions. So when gold react with NO3 minus and Cl minus ions, these are from acids, we will get a complex compound known as AuCl4 minus. AuCl4 minus, this is very very important. So this AuCl4 minus is called tetrachloro R8. Here gold oxidation number is 3 plus 3, so that's why we have to write in a Stock notation method, so Roman number, tetrachloro R8 ion. So what is the complex formed when gold react with aqua regia? AuCl4 minus. AuCl4 minus. In addition to that, we will get NO gas also. What we will get? NO gas also. And H2O. Similarly, when platinum react with aqua regia, that is HNO3 and HCl mixture, we will get hexachloroplatinate. Hexachloroplatinate 4 ion. So what is its formula? PtCl6 2 minus or minus 2. PtCl6 minus 2. So what is the another gas liberated? NO gas. Same NO gas is liberated in two cases. But these two complexes are very very important for objective examination. This question is asked in 2014 KSET examination. 2014 KSET examination. Next, reaction with the salts of weak acids. Very simple. When HCl react with salts of weak acid, salts of acid are salts, what happen? We will get again strong salts. Again strong salts. Say some examples. HCl decomposes salts of weak acids such as carbonates, hydrogen carbonates and sulfates. Say for example Na2CO3 plus HCl, we will get strong salt, that is NaCl and H2O and CO2 gas. If any carbonate salts are treated with HCl, we will get carbon dioxide gas. If any sulfite salts are treated, we will get sulfur dioxide gas. Sulfur dioxide gas. So this is the reaction with salts. Reaction with the salts, we will get strong salts. Next, not only salts of weak acids, some metal sulfides, metal phosphates as well as metal nitrates are also decomposed by hydrochloric acid. Decomposed by hydrochloric acid. So here corresponding gases we will get. So if sulfides treated with HCl, we will get hydrogen sulfide. If phosphide is treated with HCl, we will get phosphide. If NaNO2 is treated with HCl, we will get NO as well as NO2 gas. NO as well as NO2 gas. So this is about chemical properties of HCl. Chemical properties of HCl. Next, uses. What is the use of HCl? Used as a laboratory reagent in the preparation of aqua regia, extracting glue from bones and in purifying bone black. Next, in the manufacture of chlorine, ammonium chloride and glucose. So these are the uses of HCl. Next, another topic is oxo acids of chlorine. This is important for subjective as well as objective. Very simple topic. Oxo acids of chlorine. So before going to oxo acids of chlorine, if you take fluorine, fluorine forms only one oxo acid, that is known as HOF. Oxo acid means contains oxygen as well as hydrogen. HOF, HOF, it is known as fluoric acid. What is it one? Fluoric acid or hypofluorous acid. Hypofluorous acid. Remaining halogens means chlorine, bromine, iodine forms HOX, HXO2, HXO3 and HXO4 type of oxo acids. Oxo acids. Particularly, we will discuss about chlorine oxo acids. Chlorine oxo acids. Please remember, chlorine forms four types of oxo acids. They are hypochlorous acid, chlorous acid, chloric acid, perchloric acid. I repeat, hypochlorous acid, chlorous acid, chloric acid, perchloric acid. Hypochlorous, chlorous, chloric, perchloric. Formula is also very simple. First one is HClO. HClO, HClO. Second one is HClO2. Just increase the number of oxygens. HClO3, HClO4. So what is the ionic form of this one? Just by removing H, we can write one negative charge. So that's why OCl- or ClO-. Here ClO2-, ClO3-, ClO4-. So this is a common form, this is ionic form. And these are the oxidation states of chlorine. Plus 1, plus 3, plus 5, plus 7. So hypochlorous acid, chlorous acid, chloric acid, perchloric acid. Their formulas and oxidation states. So next come to one by one. Hypochlorous acid, HClO or ClO minus. In this, chlorine undergoes sp3 hybridization. Chlorine undergoes sp3 hybridization. What is the chlorine oxidation state? Plus 1. So that's why if you want to calculate number of lone pairs, just we have to apply this formula. That is group number minus oxidation state. So 7 minus 1. 7 minus 7 is what? Group number of chlorine. So halogens are 7th group elements. Oxidation state is plus 1. 6. 7 minus 1 means 6. 6 means how many pairs? 3 lone pairs present on chlorine atom. 3 lone pairs present on chlorine atom. So what is the hybridization of chlorine? Sp3. Not only in hypochlorous acid, whatever you take, chlorine undergoes sp3 hybridization only. Chlorine undergoes sp3 hybridization only. Next, chlorous acid, HClO2 or ClO2 minus. Chlorine undergoes sp3, lone pairs 2. Just apply this formula, 7 minus 3. 7 is group number, na? 3. 7 minus 3 means 4. 4 means 2 lone pairs you will get. You will get 2 sigma and 1 pi bond between chlorine and oxygen atom. Chlorine and you take chlorine. So this is a single bond. Single bond means sigma bond. In a multiple bond, one is sigma bond, another one is pi bond. So that's why between chlorine and oxygen atom, one sigma bond, sorry, two sigma bonds, one pi bond is present. Next, chloric acid. Chloric acid, HClO3 or ClO3 minus. This is the structure. It has pyramidal structure. So here, what is the oxidation state of chlorine? Plus 5. So 7 minus 5 means 2. 2 means 1 lone pair. Same, chlorine undergoes sp3 hybridization. Between chlorine and oxygen, what type of bonds we have? 1, 2, 3. 3 sigma bonds. And this is 1 pi bond, this is 1 pi bond. 2 pi bonds we have in chloric acid. Next, last one is perchloric acid, HClO4 or ClO4 minus. HClO4 or ClO4 minus. Here chlorine undergoes sp3 hybridization. On chlorine we don't have any lone pairs. 7 minus 7. 7 minus 7 means 0. No lone pairs on chlorine. So it has a tetrahedral structure. Tetrahedral structure. So in this tetrahedral structure, between chlorine and oxygens, we have 4 sigma bonds and 3 pi bonds. 4 sigma bonds and 3 pi bonds. Geometry is tetrahedral geometry. This is about oxo acids of chlorine. Oxo acids of chlorine. So the last important point is, if you take different oxo acids, which is greater acidic, greater the oxidation state, greater is the acidic. So that's why, which is stronger acid? Perchloric acid is stronger acid. Which is weaker acid? Hypochlorous acid is weaker acid. So this is about oxo acids of chlorine. In oxo acids of chlorine, what is the hybridization of chlorine? Common, that is sp3. Sp3, lone pairs are different. That is based on acid. Hypochlorous acid means we have one type of lone pairs. Chlorous acid means we have one type of lone pairs. Chloric acid means we have one type. And perchloric means we have one type of acids. That is lone pair electrons. Hope you are preparing well for Sunday's objective examination, that is polymers. So in the next class or Friday, I will give some tips how to prepare. So what type of questions you have to prepare in polymers objective examination. Thank you.